Have a great day, dear students. Today we are going to see the chapter 1, which comes under the title Multimedia and Desktop Publishing. So here, the phenomenal growth of multimedia technologies and applications with the help of computers comes with the great challenges and opportunities in the field of computers. And nowadays, in this quarantine time, multimedia apps plays a vital role, important role in the terms of presenting the information to the user. So here, the word multimedia consists of two words, multi and media. So from the name itself, we can understand that it is a multiple form of media which are combined together for communicating or giving the information to the user with the help of text or images or graphics or with the help of even animation. So in the quarantine ad, how to wash your hands, they are giving with an animation movies and ads. So this is called as a multimedia, which used to convey the information. Next topic we are going to see is components of multimedia. There are 5 major components of multimedia: text, video, audio, animation and graphics. In the dynamic elements are video, animation, audio, and then static elements are text and graphics. Here, static elements which does not have movements are called as static elements, and dynamic elements which are having the movements in images or videos. And the next topic we are going to see is text. So text is a basic component of multimedia, which is used as a common way for communication. So if you want to communicate with
other person or to deliver the information, we can use the component as text. So in the text, we can see two types, that is static text and hypertext. In that, static text are the words will remain as static as a heading or a line in a paragraph, and these words are given along with the images. In this example picture, you can see 3D is an word or a text which cannot change till to the end, but it is a text which supports an image, and these texts are called as static text. Next topic we are going to see about hypertext. Hypertext is a system which consists of notes, the text and the links between the notes, which define the path the user need to follow for the next text access in non-sequential way. So, as you have studied in HTML, what is a hyperlink? While clicking that link, we are getting connected with another web pages. Likewise, we are getting connected with the text, or from one part of the text in a page, there are number of text. From one text to another text, we are getting connected. That is not in a sequential order, not in a proper way. Randomly we are getting connected with the text within the pages. Now it is said to be as an hypertext. So if an author of working system is created this structure, the user is permitted to define their own path, and while creating the text, the readability of the text depends on the spacing and the punctuation. So while we are representing or giving information by using the component text, we must specify the text with punctuations, and the message communication is more appropriate with the improved font and styles.